So first of all, I would like to thank our financial supporters, the Embassy of Mongolia to Australia, and the Crawford School and the School of Culture, History and Language, and the College of Asia and the Pacific. Without their generous financial support, this update wouldn't have been possible. So thank you very much again. And second, I would like to show my deepest gratitude to our speakers. Thanks to the personal connections and diplomatic skills of Ambassador Bolt, we were able to put together a very high-profile speakers together. And you might have realized these speakers from Mongolia, they are all very busy people wearing with different hats. And so without ambassadors' you know, personal connections and diplomatic skill, we wouldn't have been able to attract them to our panel. So thank you very much. Our speakers really have come here for this update just for 2-3 days, and it is a long journey from Ulaanbaatar to here. You know, you have to either transit in Seoul or Beijing, and you have to wait for the next flight for several hours, and this is a tiring job, we all know. And so I really appreciate to have you here, and thank you very much again. And I also would like to thank Ondrega, who is our, one of our students and our last speaker. Even though she's based here in ANU, right now she's really in the last stage of her PhD writing. And everybody who has written a PhD would know, you know, the last stage, you wouldn't really want to do anything else than just, you know, write. But still, she was willing to spare some time and preparing the talk today. Thank you very much. Yeah. And third, I would like to thank many people who are willing to help this update. First of all, I would like to thank Ambassador Bolt for his strong support throughout this, from the planning to the execution of the update, for his personal assistant advice and support. And my very personal thanks to Mr. Hantelka of the attache of the Mongolian Embassy, who has been really, you know, liaising with all the speakers and taking care of them so well in the last couple of days, and he is probably gone for to prepare the reception. He has been a really efficient organizer. Sometimes it's too efficient. Came into my office and then see 6-7 emails from him. Did you book the lunch? Yes. Next email. Did you book the tea? So it is very banal thing, but this kind of banal thing is really important to be reminded to organize this kind of event. So I'm really thankful for his assistance and help. There are many people at the ANU who helped me to organize this conference. First of all, I would like to thank Professor Robert Griff, not only for his advice and insight for organizing this kind of event, but also for his generous offer to ask his personal assistant to create this wonderful brochure for us. So it is on his own cost, basically. Yeah. So thank you very much. His personal assistant, Sir Daniel Chow, who made this. And then in relation to this beautiful brochure, I would like to thank Mr. Peter Scoof. Did I pronounce you your name correctly? Skies. Yeah, okay, sorry. For allowing us to use this beautiful picture which he took in Mongolia. And in our earlier promotion, first promotion flyer, we've got, we have recognized his name, as the author of this photograph. But while in the last minute, while Daniel was preparing this brochure, he sort of forgot to put it back again. So that's why on this brochure, your name is not marked. I apologize personally to you, but I do this in the public as well. So thank you very much. I would like to thank Kelvin Lawrence, who took the pain to print out all the names of the participants, made the name tag for us, and then made the participant list. He is already gone. And then also the Mongolian students in Canberra. The students' community have been really very helpful. I would like to mention a few names. In particular, I would like to thank Margaret and his girlfriend, Shiro, who has been sitting outside for the whole day, actually, guiding the participant into here and doing the registration for us. And then I would like to also thank you, Naren Toya, for helping me, finding out photos and trying to find out participants and so forth, and promoting the Mongolia update. Also Itkel, who has a little boy who has been here around with this little boy here, with a red dress, young girl, who just came to me one day and said, I heard that you are organizing a Mongolia update. What can I do for you? And I was so thankful for her. And actually, just a couple of nights ago, she sent me at night saying, the date is approaching, so can I do something? And she did help me with something, and she was offering me to come here to help with registration and on the floor here, but I didn't agree with that because she has got a 3-year-old toddler, and as being mother of 3 toddlers, I know how difficult it is actually to accept any extra bit of job. And so for that reason, I really appreciated her offer to help. Yeah. And then, of course, I would like to thank our chairs, especially to those who accepting to chair the sessions on a very short note. Yeah. I think overall I'm very happy with the result. I think it was a successful one, thanks to all of your help and support. And I have learned a lot myself. And one of the things came to my mind was that, or at least it came through the talks. Became to me very clear that there are a lot of problems and challenges in Mongolia, but if we, it seems to me that speakers to suggest that if we go back to our roots, to our tradition, probably we have actually a lot of chance to succeed. And it seems to me that even the irresponsible individualism was touched upon by Professor Babar. It seems to me that it is not the tradition of the Mongols. It's rather actually the result of the 80 years of very tight controlled planned political system, actually, which created this kind of irresponsible individualistic ideas in the post reform. Because, you know, 80 years is very long time, and then you were so controlled, then suddenly open, so you wanted to be free, so you wanted to experiment, you know, what is the possibility and what is the limits are. So I think if we go back and find our responsible individualism in our nomadic culture, that would be a good thing as well, probably, yeah. I'm very conscious of this time, but last but not the least, I would like to thank you, all of you, for coming and for participating. Without the interested audience, even with a very high profile, very professional panel, the update would have been meaningless. So thank you very much for your participation.